Boxing star Edison Miranda in hot water this morning. The FBI is looking for him. I'm here, Ricky Funes. Ricky, you trained him for a little bit. Are you shocked? I mean, let's tell people what's going on. Basically, the FBI was doing this big sting to catch people drug smuggling, money laundering, and I guess his job was to smuggle the money. So they raided places in Colombia, where he's from, Puerto Rico.
And Florida.
And they arrested 28 people, but he's one of four people that they couldn't find. Are you surprised you trained him? He was a good dude when he was here?
He was a good dude, but he ripped me off and Eric B off for $5,000.
How?
Not only that. This was his scheme when he was out here. He was a cool guy, everything. He's that type of guy that will make you fall in love with his personality and friendship. So he used to like high expensive stuff. So we would go to like True Religion and he would buy pants to his certain friends. $500 pair of pants, $700, whatever it may be. And like 2 weeks later, he'll tell him, hey, let me borrow $1,000 and I'm gonna give you $1,500 back on top of that $1,000. And he would do that. And in the end, he ended up screwing me, which I borrowed money from Eric, which it was like, how much was it, Eric?
It was $2,000.
$2,000.
What did they promise you in return? Four?
15, an extra five, I think it was.
Wow, so you gave two, you'd get back seven? That deal's too good to be true,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, no, but it did.
Unless he's printing the money in his backyard.
Not only that, he ripped my buddy Sergio for $20,000.
The manager?
No, another guy.
Oh.
Another guy, yeah.
He
ripped a lot of people. He will go to the... He made a lot of friends out here.
Yeah.
There was a liquor store where 7-Eleven is. And there's an old lady that was there. He called her. He goes, hey, send me $1,500 and I'm going to give you $3,000 in return. He did that. Never got their money back. We went to the Peruvian restaurant. Same thing. $900 to one of the bus boys.
But Ricky,
them.
At what point did you know that he wasn't going to pay back?
No.
Because he kept
going? Because after he lost to...
Lucien Butte.
He came back. He made $250,000 for that fight. And we knew that he made some money, but we didn't know that he was in debt. So he kept borrowing money from different people and just burned all of us, man. I got screwed by him.
So what do you say now? The FBI is looking for
good. Fuck him.
Nah, you shouldn't say that. I don't wish bad on nobody.
Hey,
man.
I'm not wishing bad, but you know, it's like me. I did a crime, Ellie. I'm gonna have to do my time. Same thing with him. He did a crime.
I hope you don't have to do your time. I wish you the best.
But I'm just saying that if I did my crime, I don't want to do it, but I'm gonna have to do it because I did the crime. Same thing with him. It applies to anybody that...
As they say, smile now, cry later.
Yeah. Like, once you do that crime, you have to pay your debt.
So you're not shocked when you heard about this on the news?
No, because
I'm shocked. I didn't expect that.
Eventually, I knew he was going to get into something deeper where it's going to be easy money, where he's used to living that lifestyle. And it came to that point.
Drug trafficking, money laundering. You get your percentage, your 4%, 4.5%.
It all depends. If you got good people take care of you and all that, you get well taken care of. And I don't know the deal with him, but I mean...
But listen, he had a very rough childhood. He grew up on the streets. He was 15 years old eating out of garbage cans. He told me...
Ellie, I grew up in a tough neighborhood, and just like many other people out there, I got a lot of friends that grew up really tough neighborhood and are doing well.
They're not screwing anybody.
No, they're not screwing anybody. I'm sure probably whatever it may be, but they're doing good. I screw up when I was in and out of jail when I was young. I screw up. I used to gangbang. I used to do a lot of shit. I used to hurt people, and I'm doing good. I'm not trying to hurt anybody no more.
Abby, you're a role model. You're helping kids stay on the street. How about this? What do you tell Edison Miranda if he's watching?
Yeah, good luck on your case. You know, just good luck.
Can you evade the federal authorities?
Hell no. They'll catch you sooner or later.
They're on to you. Once they want you,
they'll find you.
They're going to invest any amount of money.
They know where you are, and they just let you slip and keep adding more charges. And sooner or later, they just kind of come down on you.
But you know what I notice with the federal government? Sometimes, I'm not joking, they give you a notice. We're coming to arrest you in 2 days. We're going to come arrest you in 72 hours. They do that. And some people just take that opportunity like, oh, okay, shit's going to go down. Let me try my luck.
Hey, I wish that was the case when they came to my house. Normally they wait raid your house like around 5, 6 in the morning.
Yeah.
I went home and I knew already, you know, that I called my lawyer. I go, Mike, this is what happened. He goes, Ricky, there's nothing we could do until you get arrested.
Yeah.
So I went home. I prepared myself. And I said, well, they're going to come early in the morning. I get there 10 o'clock. And it's so quiet around my neighborhood, you know, it's really quiet. And at midnight, boom, 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 boom. Open the fucking door.
Wow.
You know, knocking the shit down. They shut down the whole street, my whole community where I'm at. I go, man, you serious? It was embarrassing. It was really embarrassing, Ellie. And they'll find you.
Yeah.
They wanted to knock down my walls. Yeah. The detective said, where's the gun at? I go, I don't know. I got to talk to my lawyer. You got to talk to my lawyer. Oh, they got my, he goes, well, we don't have to talk to him. We'll knock the doors and I just remodel my house.
Yeah.
He goes, we're going to break down your whole
house,
walls and everything. I go, go ahead, as long as the city pays for it.
Yeah.
And he tried to be smart. And he goes, all right. And he didn't break them down.
No, they threatened to see when you'll crack.
Yeah.
I've watched a lot of Law and Order. I'm an expert.
Oh, same thing with my safe. I have a big safe. And he goes, do you have a gun? I go, here's the keys.
Yeah.
I'm not stupid. I knew they were coming. So I give him the keys to my safe. And
But listen, cops are not the smartest. And no offense to any cop watching. They're regular people. Sometimes you'll have one that's very clever. But they're just people. And sometimes they try to be actors.
They're like good cops and bad cops.
But in the end, they're all cops.
But I got a lot of friends that are cops, but...
Some of my best friends are cops.
Are they really?
No, it's a joke. You know what? Never mind.
But no, yeah,
I know. Listen, they're good and bad everywhere. But I'm saying just because someone's a doctor doesn't mean he knows everything. Just because someone's a police officer doesn't mean they'll solve everything.
And let me tell you something. Some of these cops that work gang unit, gang relay, they work the beat, they never grew up in the hood.
So they go to
gang seminars to find out what's really going on. And they know a lot of stuff. They travel to different countries, like to Salvador and Honduras, where they have these fucking really crazy third world country gangs. And they do seminars on these kind of gangs. But they never grew up, and they assume, but they call them gang experts.
All right, there you have it. Ricky Funes, maybe you could be a police expert. EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Ali Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback.